goalkeepers tend to do. And that ball was played through to him, but here's Maradona again. He has Burchaga to his left and Valdano to his left. He won't need any of them. Oh, you have to say that's magnificent. There is no debate about that goal. That was just pure football genius. And the crowd in the Azteca Stadium stand to him. Inside one, away from another. And the coolness under pressure to play the ball home with the side of his foot. If the first was illegal, the second was one of the best goals we've seen in this championship. And there is a very dejected man, beaten once unfairly, beaten on a second occasion, like so many of his colleagues, by sheer skill. Just over 10 minutes of the second half gone, and Argentina have a two-goal lead, and England now have to gamble. They've got to give it all. Santam. That's a good try. Turned away by Ruggeri. The goals unquestionably have brought the game to life. But they are asking the questions now of what Bobby Robson's men have to offer. They have to throw away any inhibitions, and they certainly show plenty of those in the first period. First time we've seen Butcher up in the opposition 18-yard area. Beardsley and Cacciuffo, Ruggeri and Lineker. And we've seen very little of Gary Lineker in this contest. And the referee having sharp words about what seemed to him to be time wasting. Schuster. Huddle gets away with the acrobatics. Hodge. Young man in turmoil at the moment, Steve Hodge. Because it was his missed kick which produced the first goal. Albeit for the fact that we believe that Maradona put the ball in with his hand. Butcher. Certainly a moment for those who have made their journey out from Britain. There are plenty of Scots who stayed on to watch England after the departure of their own team. It's certainly a moment for them to make themselves heard. Beardsley. Been tightly marked all the time by Cacciuffo, but has battled all the way. Whatever the outcome of this contest, it's surely right to say that Beardsley has grown into an international player during this tournament. And that was Hodge, and Pumpidou did well to get there, and needed to from Argentina's point of view. A flick on. And Hodge found a goalkeeper and defender to deny him. Steven to take the corner. England, to their credit, have pressed from the moment of going one behind. when all's said and done and we look at our own heroes back home, some of them being sold expensively to Italy, I think in all honesty we can say that there is no light that shines as brightly as Maradona's. He can do it on his own, he can lay on goals for other people, he can take part in inter-passing movements, he has fantastic pace when it's necessary, and also tremendous strength. He's won a couple of heading competitions already in midfield, and that final one, unfair or not, he still read the back pass quicker than Shilton did, and it was running away from him, you have to remember, and towards Shilton.
Peter Reid was hurt in that challenge, free kick given against Batista, whose name was taken by the referee, Batista. That's his first booking in the championship. Hoddle with the free kick. Brown, did it brush his head or not? Yes, it did, said the linesman. Hoddle coming across to take the corner. And that's Carlos Bilardo, the coach of Argentina. And from the other bench, Chris Waddle is warming up for England. Glenn Hoddle with the corner. Not a good one. And Hoddle really has to get more involved in this match if England are to save it. Beardsley came through the crowd. The sting, I think, was taken off it. But he timed his movement into the area so well. It didn't really get hold of it. And neither almost did the goalkeeper. He saw it very late, it seems. Stevens. Fenwick and Gary Stevens. Terry Butcher. Reid wants it in midfield. And it would be good to see Terry Butcher with a score at 0-2 try to bring the ball forward, but preferably to use it rather better than that. Buruchaga. Fenwick. Reid. Sansa wants it on the left side. This is Hoddle. Reid. Beardsley. As always, Cutrufo at his back. He's done well. Pass just a little bit too high. Olatico Echea. And the number being held by the FIFA official down in front of us would seem to indicate that Peter Reid will be the man who England will bring off. Butcher. Santam. Saldano. Trevor Stephen. His touch has not been what it was against Paraguay or against Poland. Could be said of a number of England players. Certainly he and Hodge have not been the factors that they were in the last two games. And Lineker and Beardsley really have not had the service of those games. England want to make the substitution. Chris Waddle is waiting. The ball is in the crowd. And the announcement of the substitution is made on the public address system, and off comes Peter Reid, who plays